Hi everyone, my name is Lee and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, I'm going to show you how to level up your 3D modeling game with a new Cinema 4D tool. Today's 3D modeling tool is called Bridge. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how it works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D and we're going to practice using the Bridge tool. I have these spheres here and we're going to bridge them all together. So if I hit MB, that is how you activate the bridge tool, and you can see bridge is in my attribute manager after using that hotkey MB. And here we can begin bridging these together, and there's different ways you can do it. I'm going to go into edge mode for right now, and in order to select this loop around here, I'll use UL, and that'll select a loop. So I can select this loop, and I can select this edge loop as well. And then after I do that, I can use the hotkeys MB for bridge, and just connect these two. You can choose how many subdivisions you would like when you bridge these two surfaces together. And this is what it looks like when I increase this. You can see what it looks like to increase or decrease the tension. And that'll control the shape of your form some. You may be able to see what this is doing a little bit more from this point of view. So we can create some interesting shapes doing that. And I think just for fun, I'm going to bridge all of these across this entire shape. So I've gone through and I've bridged all of these together so that now they're one shape. It's a good way to practice. And you can also bridge together polygons. So if we go into polygon mode instead of edge mode, you can select a polygon here and bridge it to another polygon just like that. Sometimes what I like to do, I'm going to hit undo, Control Z to undo that. Sometimes what I like to do is actually select the polygons first before I bridge them together with MB, because that seems to offer me more accuracy and more control when I'm choosing what I'd like to bridge together. So I prefer to work that way, but there's no one right or wrong way to do this necessarily. If you'd rather like to just drag from one polygon to another in order to bridge them, you can. And you have the same options as before. You can adjust the tension. You can adjust the number of subdivisions when you bridge. So you still have that complete control that you had before when we were bridging with the edge selection. And just so that you're aware, if you wanted to, you could just pick two edges, use MB again in edge mode, and bridge them together like this. And now we have this really interesting form going through here. And again, you can adjust the tension of how you would like this surface to look and adjust the number of subdivisions. Something else that you can do, that looks like the letter A. Something else you can do is, I'm going to hide this initially, you can also bridge together points. So in the last episode, I went over how to use add point, and that is how I created these points here, is using the add point tool. So if you want to learn how to create your own points, you can watch that previous episode, episode 5, to see how to use add point. But I'm going to move forward. So right now I'm in point mode and I'm in this polygon, empty polygon that has these points in it. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead and click MB again to bring up our bridge hotkey, and I'll go ahead and connect these two points together. And now we've bridged these two points, so that actually creates a line. But we can also bridge this with these other two points, and now we've created a polygon. So you have that kind of ability where you can bridge everything from points, edges, to polygons to create some interesting shapes. It's a really powerful 3D modeling tool. It gives you a lot of control if you start getting into surfacing, and you can make so many interesting shapes with it right away. This is really more abstract, showing how to create something with the tool, but you can really 3D model anything. Something else that I want to show you before moving on and ending this episode is just one more option in here. And for right now, I'm going to go ahead and connect these two polygons as an example with bridge. You'll see that we have this option called spin steps. And here you can actually add some twist to how these are connecting in here. And this works better if you have more subdivisions, so I suggest doing that if you want to try this out. And you can also choose what kind of surfacing you'll get in between polygons. So here, I'll connect these two, and this is what normal mode looks like. You can try surface mode, and it alters how Cinema 4D is calculating how the surface is being made. So you can try out these different options to see what they look like. And I hope you found today's tutorial helpful. And if you did and you want to learn more 3D modeling tools, please hit like and subscribe to be notified when I come out with a new 3D modeling tool. And thank you for watching.